Okay, just a small case we get. Last month I presented one patient with interesting autoimmune disorder, which was TTP, thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. So I will be presenting another interesting autoimmune condition, which is very rare. So this is a 45 year old man who came with extensive ecchymosis of the leg and the foot, next, anterior abdominal wall, next, and then forearm. So he had extensive ecchymosis, arm, forearm, and abdominal wall. So he had some bleeding diathesis, but his blood counts were normal, his platelet count was normal. Next thing. Normal platelet count, but his APTT was prolonged. That means his activated partial thrombotic time. Prothrombin time was normal. So it was an isolated, prolonged APTT with the bleeding diathesis. So in this situation, what we do? We want to prove that there is some deficiency. So we do what is called a mixing test. We take the patient's plasma and mix it with the normal plasma. If it corrects, it is a deficiency. If it doesn't correct, it's an inhibitor. So there could also be an inhibitor. Next way. So we did a 50-50 mix with the normal plasma. If it corrects its deficiency, if it doesn't, it's inhibitor. This patient, there was no correction. So there was an inhibitor to the coagulation factor. It didn't correct with the normal plasma. Next one. So then we did a factor assay. Both factor 8 and 9 were very low. Then we did an inhibitor assay. There were inhibitors to factor 8. Of course, we didn't prove the inhibitor to factor 9 because there was no thing available. But we could easily prove that there was an inhibitor to factor 8. So it was a low factor, severely low factor 8, which we call it due to inhibitor. So this is what's called acquired hemophilia, not a congenital hemophilia. This patient has had 3 surgeries in the past, no bleeding diathesis, nothing so far in his life. Only this started as a new onset bleeding diathesis. So it's an acquired factor 8 deficiency. It's an autoimmune condition due to an inhibitor directed against the factor 8, which we proved it because it didn't mix with the normal plasma. That is inhibitor, and we proved it's a low factor 8. Next. So it is due to inhibitors, it's an autoimmune condition. It's very, very rare, extremely rare. Extremely rare in child children and very rare in adults. So it happens usually in adult populations. It's called acquired hemophilia as opposed to congenital factor 8 deficiency. Next. So management is, we can't give factor 8 because whatever factor 8 you give, it will get neutralized because of the inhibitor. So you have to give what is called factor 8 bypass activity, which is a prothrombin complex concentrate, very expensive, prohibitively expensive. Or you can give what's called recombinant factor 7A. These are all ready-made coagulation, activated coagulation factors. If the patient is bleeding very severely, life-threatening bleeding, if he's compromised hemodynamically, you may have to use this. If the patient is stable, we just give immunosuppressive therapy. Next slide. That's all. So immunosuppressive therapy, you can give it steroids, cyclophosphamide, or anti-CD20 monoclonal antibody. So this patient, we did give factor 8 bypass activity and we did give immunosuppression, but unfortunately we couldn't salvage him because he died of some other cardiac comorbidity. He was extremely obese, extensive bleeding diathesis, but it's an extremely rare condition, a very rare autoimmune disorder. So last month, if you just recapture it, I presented a thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, which is an autoimmune condition directed against 1 milligram factor antigen. 1 milligram clearing enzyme. This is an antibody against factor 8, which is an acquired hemophilia. Thank you. It's very important to recognize this condition.
I request Dr. Parmar to come forward and handle the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Krishna.